All right, the parable of the evil farmers. Now Jesus turned to the people again and told them this story. A man planted a vineyard, leased it to tenant farmers, and moved to another country to live for several years. At the time of the grape harvest, he sent one of his servants to collect his share of the crop, but the farmers attacked the servant, beat him up, and sent him back empty-handed. So the owner sent another servant. But they also insulted him, beat him up, and sent him away empty-handed. A third man was sent, and they wounded him and chased him away. What will I do? The owner asked himself. I know, I'll send my cherished son. Surely they will respect him. But when the tenant farmers saw his son, they said to each other, here comes the heir to this estate. Let's kill him and get the estate for ourselves. So they dragged him out to the vineyard, murdered him. What do you suppose the owner of the vineyard will do to them? Jesus asked. I'll tell you. He will come and kill those farmers and lease the vineyard to others. How terrible is such a thing should ever happen? His listeners protested. Jesus looked at him and said, The stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. They were appalled at this, the leaders of this time, because they understood that Jesus was talking about them. Now, this parable is to say that God has sent many to come and collect his harvest, collect his grapes. This world is his vineyard. Servants of the Most High have been planted here. And the world kills whom God sends to collect his people. Such a beautiful, beautiful story. And the owner of the vineyard, which is God, is going to come and clear the entire table. Because those that lease it, the people of this world, who are living on borrowed time, keep killing whom God sends to deliver his message, to deliver his people. So God's getting ready to clear the board.